Hello everyone, in this lecture we will see shear force. Okay, so see, here it is a shear, here it is a beam. Okay, beam AB. This horizontal beam is supported by two support section. At left side it is hinged support, at right side it is roller support, and this beam is acted by vertical downward force P. Okay. At right end, reaction vertical direction will develop RA, and at end B, vertical reaction force will develop, that is RP. So the reaction force will be P by 2 and P by 2, and shear force will develop at any section. Okay. See, if we cut any section, here it is a cut section. If we cut any section, then inside view will be like this. That is here. On left side it is downward force, and on right side it is upward force. Okay. Now we will see sign conventions for shear force. If we take any part of a beam, and on that part, if left side has vertical force and right side has downward force, then this type of shear force is called as positive shear force. Okay, this type of shear will cause a clockwise rotation. See, here it is a clockwise rotation. These two forces will cause clockwise rotation. And likewise, if a section of a beam will produce, if on that section, on left side it is downward force and on right side it is upward force, and these two type forces beam, and if these two forces will produce anti-clockwise rotation, then this type of shear is negative shear force. Okay. So for sign convention it is important to, you should have to see it carefully. Okay, what is a positive shear force and what is a negative shear force? We will calculate shear force by taking either sum of all forces on left side of that section, or sum of all forces on right side of that section, particular section. Okay. Now we will see what is a bending moment. See, same beam acted by point load P. The reaction force will be RA and RB, P by 2. Okay. And at a section, any section XX, this type of shear force and moment will act. See, shear force is SX. Okay. Left side it is downward, right side is upward. And the bending moment is mx. Okay. Now, to calculate bending moment, we have to take bending moment is a force into perpendicular distance. Okay. So, see, considering equilibrium of left hand free body diagram, this portion will remain in equilibrium if all three conditions will meet. Okay, all three condition will meet. So first condition is already satisfied. By applying second condition, RA and RB is calculated, and by applying third condition, that is sum of moment along any point is zero, by applying this condition we will get moment at point X. Okay, at point X or section XX. So moment will be RA into X. X is a distance from point A to the section XX. Okay. So RA into X minus MX is equal to 0. So we will get moment at section XX is a moment MX is equal to RA into X, which is equal to P by 2 into that distance from point A. Okay, P by 2 into X. So moment will be P by 2 into x. Hence bending moment at section xs is resultant of algebraic sum of moment caused by transverse forces either from left or right of section. Sign conventions for bending moment. If the upper surface of beam will produce concavity, okay, then this type of bending moment is a positive bending moment or sagging bending moment. And if lower surface or downward surface of a beam will cause concavity, then this type of bending moment is a negative bending moment or hugging bending moment. Now see the example for SFD and BMD. How to calculate shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Here it is a beam AB. At the midpoint of beam AB, here it is point C, and the point load is acting. Point load is capital P. The support reaction at point A is horizontal reaction HA and vertical reaction RA, and at point B it is RB. The vertical reaction is equal and half, that is P by 2 and P by 2. For SFD and BMD, first calculate all support reaction by using condition of static equilibrium, that are see. We have to calculate first RA and RB. Okay. See, summation of Fx is equal to 0, first condition. From that equation, you will get horizontal reaction at point A is equal to 0. Now considering second condition, summation of Fy is equal to 0, that is RA plus RB is equal to P. So RA here, up to this, RA and RB are unknown to us. So we will write it as equation number 1. Mm-hmm. Now considering third condition, that is taking summation of moment about point B. Sum of moment at point B is equal to 0. So RA into L minus P into L by 2. See, moment at point B, RA, distance of RA in distance of point A and B will be capital L. So RA into capital L, that is P by 2 into capital L. And this moment is a clockwise moment. This moment is a clockwise moment, right? So here it is a positive, and capital P, this force is downward force, and this force will cause anti-clockwise moment, so it is a negative moment. So RA, that is P by 2 into capital L, this is positive, and P into L by 2 is a negative. See, RA into capital L minus P into L by 2 is equal to 0. From this equation, we will get RA is equal to P by 2. By putting this value in equation number 1, so we will get RB, value of RB, which is also equal to P by 2. So both reactions, that is RA and RB, are equal, that is P by 2. Okay. Now we will see what is the SFD and BMD diagram. First we will see SFD. To plot SFD diagram, that is to calculate the shear force at various sections on a beam, we will use method of section. We will take one by one portion. For SFD, we will take first portion, that is portion AC, that is this is point A and this point is C. So we will take portion AC. Now considering section at section xx in portion AC at a distance x from A. Any section xx, this section xx will be at any point on portion AC. Okay. Now see, shear force at a section xx, that is xx small x from A. Okay. the distance from that section from point A will be small x. Okay, so shear force will be Ra into small x. Okay, Ra into small x, where small x is the distance from point A to the section xx. Okay, and small x will be from 0 to L by 2. Okay, small x will be from 0 to L by 2. And these shear force will remain constant from support A and just left of the point C. Okay, left of point C. As it is a point load, both are point load. Ra is a point load and capital P is a point load. So, the shear force will remain constant from point A to the point C. And this value of shear force is Ra into small x. Okay. Now, second portion is portion CB. Now, consider section XX in portion CB at a distance X from A. So, shear force will be sum of vertical forces. We will take a section on section XX, this section, okay, from point C to B, section XX. The first force will be Ra plus Ra, P, Ra and minus P, okay, Ra minus P. Okay, we will take all forces left side of section XX, that are first force is Ra and second force is P. Ra is a vertically upward, so we will take it as positive, and P is vertically downward, so we will take it as negative. So Ra minus P will be, Ra minus P is our shear force at section XX. Okay, so Ra minus P. The value of Ra is P by 2, so shear force at new section XX will be minus P by 2. Okay, got it? Shear force at new section XX will be minus P by 2. Okay, shear force here, see here also from at portion CB, that is point C to B, the shear both point. The load is here, both are point load, okay. So, shear force will remain constant throughout portion CB. Okay. So, we have calculated for portion AC, shear force is Ra into X and shear force is Ra, okay. And for portion CB, it is shear force is minus P by 2, okay. So shear force diagram will be like that. For portion AC, shear force is P by 2, and for portion CB, shear force is minus P by 2. So positive P by 2 will be upward of the horizontal line. The upward side of this horizontal line is a positive P by 2, and lower side of this horizontal line is minus P by 2, okay, negative side. So we will draw a rectangle of height P by 2 upward of this horizontal line and rectangle of depth P by 2 downward to this horizontal line. Okay, this is a shear force diagram. Shear force in AC is P by 2 and shear force in BC is minus P by 2. So shear force diagram changes its sign at point C. Shear force will change its sign at point C. Okay. In next lecture, we will see how to calculate bending moment diagram for the same numerical. Okay. For this same numerical.